Well, a Melbourne family has endured a real-life nightmare. This is the moment three masked intruders armed with a gun and machetes break into their home in the early hours of Sunday morning. It is just terrifying. Gurinder Singh, his wife Harpreet, his mother and two children join us now live in Kalkallo in Melbourne's north. Thank you so much for joining us after what was a harrowing weekend for you. Gurinder, talk us through what happened.
Hi, Sarah. Good morning. We had a few people break in yesterday morning. That was 4:55 a.m. We didn't expect anyone that time of the morning will be coming into our house like that. My wife downstairs getting ready to work. She starts 6 o'clock and she's just about to leave home, and then suddenly she hears a bang, and then she thought maybe someone's fallen off the stairs, you know, break the glass or something happened. As soon as she was going upstairs, and these two guys behind her with machetes, very threatening, like fully covered up and full of with like, and there's a third guy with the gun, fully masked up and wearing all the dark clothing, so we couldn't recognize who these people were, but they were more of an African appearance people. And as soon as my wife started screaming, my mother made her way out towards the stairs, and then she was halfway down the stairs to, you know, just to try stop whatever's happening. And I heard all these noises. I woke up. I was in a deep sleep. I woke up, I got down there, and then I seen the guy dragging my mum out of the stairs and throwing her onto the ground, and she had her head split open and she had to go to the hospital. And that was later during the day. But that time I was just upstairs while trying to make my way down. The guy come up with his machete trying to attack me. I just let him attack me wherever he wanted to attack me. I just stood down there calm, because my actions when I saw the guy with the gun, I was like, if I would hit him back from the stairs, I could knock him down. But if I would have done one thing, they would have done big damage to my wife and my mum down there. And it just made me feel like I'm not feeling safe at all. Like,
no, of course not. I mean, it's
what
just
to do.
It's just so terrifying. And as you said, I mean, these guys weren't messing around, these thugs. They came there prepared. They were armed. I mean, you had little chance. Harpreet, I want to ask you how you are. You were the first to encounter them.
I'm very scared. When I saw them, like, they were behind me and they put me in the corner. And I was screaming and tried to wake them up all, because they were all asleep upstairs. And I was the one when I saw them. It was very scary. I thought this is the last day. We won't be alive till like later.
You literally feared for your lives. I mean, and this is the thing, you can see just how terrifying they are, stalking you outside your house and then harrowing as they made their way in. Gurinder, how is your mother? I mean, she suffered those injuries you mentioned there with her head slashed.
She's been shattered, like, you know, she can't speak much. She's like had a like sort of a injury in the leg. She's walking, like, you know, it's hard for her. She had a few injuries, falling off the stairs, you know. She's in her 60s, like, you know, mid-60s, so it's not right for these people to be attacking someone with that sort of age or attacking a woman. If you want something, as you know, they wanted some cash and jewelry, I helped them. I said, mate, take whatever you want, just leave us alone. But if you know, this is not something I had never seen this in my life.
Well, this is the thing though, isn't it, Gurinder? I mean, you don't expect this to happen, but we're seeing such an escalation in crime these days. What's happening? Is it something you've seen a lot of in your area?
I've seen a lot of fake registrations being parked. As soon as I drive past a random, you know, bit sussy looking car, I always get on my Vic Roads check, I do a rego check, you know, whether this guy not been plotting someone's house. And I've been informing my neighbors, hey, there's three or four cars we've been recording, we've been taking photos, sending to the police. And I didn't know that was me next getting attacked.
This is the thing though. I mean, and these thugs were stalking your house, what, like 4 a.m? I mean, they had this planned out and you're just in the safety of your own home. Do you even feel safe in your own home anymore?
No, we had to stay out last night. We stayed in a hotel And then we just came in this morning just before the interview, and we don't feel safe. And my wife had to take a day off from work, yeah. So as I did. And this is not something we should be doing. We would be moving out of here. We won't be living in Victoria the way it feels like when we call the police. There's always a wait. Look, like I understand they've been on a short staff. Mm. It's totally understandable, but they were out there in 10 minutes that when this incident happened. I imagine like all the loud sounds happen and neighbors, if someone would have called the cops a little bit earlier, we could have solved this, you know. There could have been a bit more brighter.
I mean, it's terrifying. This is happening too often. Something needs to be done about it to make you feel safe. Thank you so much for joining us. We're so sorry for what's happened, and we'll catch up with you again.